What's up, guys? Jeremy Holloway here. And, you know, I just want to make your life productive. So hit that subscribe, like if you like the content, and also some comments. I want to connect with you. Five dangerously positive questions to ask yourself. Let's go. If you were a zillionaire and you just had all the money in the world, what would you do with your life? What would be the passionate thing that you would do? This is a good question because this kind of takes away the limits of resources and things like that. And it gets to the core of who you are, number one, and number two, what's your purpose here on this life? Because the main point about that is to just understand that life isn't just about making money and then passing away. It's about a legacy. It's about leaving something behind for the people that you love. So, what is it? What would you do if you had no issues with money and time and you just could do anything? What would that one thing do? What would that one thing be? Another question that is dangerously positive that you can ask yourself is, where do you want to be in the next year, in the next 2 years, 5 years, 10 years? What are your goals for that? Or who do you want to be in the next 1 year, 5 years, 10 years? This is an important question because a lot of times we're just going about our business doing the day-to-day things, but we're not stopping to plan and be strategic about what are we here for and what are we going to do and who do we want to be in the next year? Because we can be intentional about some of these things. In the next year, I definitely want to grow in my business. I want to connect with a lot more people from different walks of life, and I just want to be a better communicator. I want to be a better leader. I want to connect really well with people, and I really want people to understand my heart and my mind. So in the next year, I want to do that even better. Here's another good question to ask yourself. What do you want people to say about you after you pass away? Or some would say at your funeral. What do you want people to say about you? And this is a good question to ask because a lot of times we push aside those things, right? But we have to begin with the end in mind, thinking about what do we want people to say about us. And a lot of times you'll be surprised at the answer, you know? Maybe you want people at first to say all kinds of amazing things, but I think sometimes you just want people to say, he was a kind person. He connected with me. He talked to me. He took time to be with me. Because at the end of everything, it's the relationships that we formed. And I'm not saying this because I'm a super expert and I have perfect relationships in every way possible. I have a lot of work to do. I'm saying this because it's a good thing to be intentional and say, you know what? I'm going to work on this while I have the opportunity. I want to work on this and be better at connecting with people, and I want to really help people in my life. So it's a good question to ask. After you pass away, what do you want people to say about you? Because right now you can do something about that. Here's another question to ask yourself. What really matters to you in your life? And are you living a life that stands on those principles that really matter to you? Write down those things. I'd encourage you to write down what really matters to you. What's the most important things to you? And then ask yourself, am I living the things that I care about the most? If you're not, what are the things that are standing in the way, or what do you think is in the way of that? And I would start working on those things now, because look, this is a life that you've been given for a purpose. So what are those things? What are those things that matter to you the most? Last question, and I think this is a great question to ask yourself every single day, in the morning and at night. That question is, what are you thankful for? What are you thankful for today? For me, it's a beautiful day outside. I'm happy to be with the people that I love. Had a good day today. Thankful for that. You know, I'm thankful for a lot. I'm thankful for you. So these kind of things, these questions, are questions that will change your life. They're dangerous in a very positive way. because they can change your life for the better. And only you can make the decision to make these changes in your life. So I encourage you, if you write down those things, it'll help you make some decisions that'll really help you go in that direction that you need to go into. A bonus question is this: how much time do you want to spend with those you love? And what are you doing to assure that you have that time that you are spending with those that you love? Because in order to live like a dog, you gotta work like a dog, right? And if you never heard that before, let me say it in a different way. You have to put forth the work at first if you want to live the life that you wanna live. So make sure that you're doing that. Make sure that you are making everything happen so that you can have that time with your family, your friends, those people that you love. And I encourage you to do that now. I would chunk out time right now. A lot of times we think that we don't have time or we don't have money to do amazing things. What we need to do is just do amazing things at the level that we feel comfortable with right now. Do amazing things right now. You know, $5 means a lot to somebody. You could take $5 from your bank and literally give that to someone to make their whole life. You could change their whole life. It doesn't cost that much money. Time. You could spend one afternoon with a person that just needs company. You know, I'm starting a company that is helping elderly and reaching out to them during this pandemic. And, you know, I believe that one phone call, one conversation can change someone's life. One moment with someone that believes in you can change your life. I started playing the guitar because I was just playing the guitar when I was a kid, and my mom just told me once, she said, "You have a really nice voice." And that really changed everything for me. I was very thankful for that. So I encourage you, one moment, it doesn't take a lot of time, it doesn't take a lot of money. Start doing it now, because the biggest lie is that not yet, not yet. You can't really do that yet. But once you get real big, then you can do that. Once you have $1 million, then you can finally take care of that person or have the party that would celebrate, you know, someone's graduation or say whatever. Do it now. Do it right now, because right now is the time, it's a gift that we have. That's one thing that I'm thankful for, is right now. So I encourage you. Live that life right now. All right, guys, I hope you liked, and I want you to subscribe, I want you to follow, I want you to do all that stuff. Let's stay connected, and I'll talk to you later. 5 dangerously positive standing on those standards. Am I living those standards? Am I living that life? Let's stay connected.